seeing that yes, this is really working. This is really doing what we're expecting to do. Is just so exciting.
Unlocking the mysteries of our universe. The James Webb Space Telescope will give us an understanding of our solar system like we've never seen before. While reaching this point took decades, the mission started right here in North Baltimore. Hello everyone, I'm Jason Newton and welcome to 11 TV Hill. We are outside of the Space Telescope Science Institute on the campus of Johns Hopkins University. It is the home of the James Webb Space Telescope, and this project is more than two decades old. And our own 11 TV Hill correspondent Tommie Clark is inside Mission Control with more on how this project began and where it's headed.
Right now, hundreds of Marylanders are working on the most powerful space telescope ever built. That includes right here in Baltimore.
Inside the flight control room of the Space Telescope Science Institute, 24 hours a day, ground engineers and command controllers are making progress 1 million miles away.
The people who tell the telescope what to do, what to look at, how to use the instruments, which way to point, all of that is happening here.
Nancy Levinson is the Institute's deputy director.
So which antenna are we talking to now?
88 days out from the next generation space telescope's launch into space, and she says the voyage has reached an alignment milestone. All 18 gold mirrors have unified to produce an image of a far-off star, at the same time revealing other galaxies.
For us, that was actually a tremendous result. We looked at a star and it looks like a star. That was very important.
The revolutionary design is delivering. The deployment process is complete.
And that really was the unfolding of the sun shield, the opening up of the telescope, undoing the origami that we needed to be folded into the rocket to be able to do the launch.
This team is one step closer to delivering the most detailed view of the cosmos ever.
To get the mirror to work as one fantastic telescope.
Levinson says the opportunity to use the telescope as an observatory is open to everyone in the world.
For all kinds of astronomers, because Webb has been decades in the making, we have been looking forward to it. We've been counting on it. We know what experiments we want to do, what kinds of observations we want to do. And seeing that yes, this is really working. This is really doing what we're expecting to do is just so exciting.
This is just the beginning. Webb will do much more than study other stars and see what solar systems are out there. It'll help solve mysteries in our solar system and map out the origins of the universe and our place in it.
So these are places where we're looking for tremendous scientific advances, but I think just all of our innate human curiosity makes them interesting. And so that's why we'll be looking forward to sharing with you and your viewers what's coming out.
So that was fascinating. I'm a space nerd, so this is a lot of fun. When it comes to the telescope, though, it is revolutionary, not just in what it does, but even how it's built.
That's right. They're pioneering a new way to build space telescopes with the Webb Telescope. And we know that this milestone that we're seeing right now, it's proving that it's a success in itself, because this optical system, it's a first of its kind, and it's working exactly as it should.
And it's cool. And this is just the infancy. We're seeing it from the very beginning. But what comes next now?
Okay, so now we got the alignment measures. This is what we're doing now, these steps. Next, in the coming months, will come these instruments that are on the Webb Telescope. We'll make sure that those are functioning correctly. And then this summer, that is when we will get the first full, photos coming from this Webb Telescope, as well as the first full science data from this, which is really exciting. I mean, just a few months out.
You're sounding like a scientist. I like it. Tommie Clark, thank you. Good as always.